Public input. Is there anybody that has anything they'd like to bring up? Discuss?
Good food.
The food is wonderful. Stephen, thank you. Alan.
I'm Alan.
I can't hear you.
Oh, longer than I can, 17 years. And I've seen a lot of people come and go. Well, the railroad, I'm on behalf of the employees, the railroad is really, as Martin talked about, is a family. We have a small nucleus, really a number of people that's not very large. And through that 17 years, I've seen some really competent, extremely experienced people. And I can name 50, 75 people over that 17 years that have come and gone. They're just excellent people. This question I wanted to direct to Gal Harper, if I could.
Sure.
Would you be willing to share some of the, from a management standpoint, management style that you found over the years to be very positive and successful at the D&S that you might bring to the C&TS? And in addition to that, maybe some things that you found successful and useful that maybe your staff doesn't have a desire to move on.
Well, first of all, the management company talked about its family. I run all my activities in business are family oriented, and I treat all the employees as family. There are no questions when you run a business. At times, you have to make decisions that aren't the most popular for an individual, but for the good of the whole. So I'm a realist that it can't all be just fun and games and everybody's going to be thrilled. But there are several things that we do. For example, every 2 years, we survey the marketplace. We want to make sure that we're keeping our salaries for different skill positions in line with market. And from a salary point, we always try to stay in the middle third. But when we overlay benefits, we try to be in the top third. So it's a combination of salary and benefits is how we work with our employees. The other thing we do is try to keep them informed. We have a preseason party meeting preparation for the season. We have a postseason party talking about everything. We give different various employee awards. We have a Christmas party. We have joint parties where we include our volunteer groups, and that seems to encourage people. We also listen. We look for ideas, and we appreciate the ideas from our employees. Now, how does that all add up? The average tenure of our full-time employees is 18 years.
Wow.
So we keep our people. We're in an age where I can honestly tell you, we will hire 5 new people for year-round employment. Within a year, we'll lose one of them. Within 2 years, we'll really train them well, and the oil and gas companies will steal them, paying them twice what I get paid. Bottom line is, by the 5th year, I've got one that will stay forever. And that's kind of the way it works. These railroads can't go and pay $27 an hour. They're crews. We just can't do it. But we do stay competitive with our salaries and more competitive with our benefits. You add the two together is how we keep people. But you know, railroaders are different people. Railroaders and people that work for railroad do it because they love the business and not the money. And so our efforts are really just trying to take care of them that's fair. And that's what I focus on. Because I know the ones that have been there forever are going to be there forever. 30 years. And you know what he started? He graduated from college, and he was the honey bucket guy. He runs the railroad.
Money, I had all the money.
His brother has been with the railroad. Same thing, graduated from Fort Lewis College. He's now the GM in Texas.
Steve Jackson, any of you in the, you all know Steve, been here, and he's older than dirt, he's been here forever. Larry Beam, we just had one retire, we've been there, how long have we been part-time? Long time. My point being is that we work as a family, you know, we thrive together, we suffer together, landslides and snowfalls and you have it. But I think it's making an atmosphere where the employees feel a part of what's going on and help make the decisions. I'd love to tell you that everyone's totally tickled to death and we'll be there forever. That doesn't happen. It's a human organization. But I think we do a good job, and I think we've become a very good neighbor in our community. We're very environmentally conscious. I won't get into that, but I can go on long stories about that. So I think that's, the atmosphere is what we create, and the way we treat people honestly and fairly, but professionally.
How many total employees do you have?
We have roughly 80 year-round, and in peak season, full-time, part-time, 220. At that railroad, similar in North Carolina, a little less in Texas, but pretty much the same.
Anything else from anybody?
Yep, Frank. Frank Stapleton, I'm from Lakewood. I had the pleasure of working on the railroad after I retired from another career for 6 summers, and I try and keep track of the sort of things. I'd like to make 2 comments. One, you were mentioning getting things from the New Mexico Surplus Donation Program. I'd have them check at Fort Carson. They renovated their rail yard, threw out all the 90-pound, put in, I think, it's 130-pound rail. And I know they were looking for switches and things not long ago. I don't know if the Colorado Surplus Property Agency functions at all anymore. I used to work that program in a previous life. But I know New Mexico still functions, so might want to look there.
Okay, good.
The other thing on marketing, I really hope that we'll see a little more in Denver, because there's 3 million people up there that know where the DNS is, but they don't know where the C&TS is. The train shows, I try and take brochures to some of the train shows. There wasn't anybody this year at the Narrow Gauge Convention in Hickory, North Carolina. I hope there will be a presence at the one in Bellingham, Washington next September. I know the Durango Silverton is in Hickory. It's just a good presence to make. And I was just in Taos, and I checked the 2 places I was in at the rack cards, nothing on the C&TS in those 2 places in Taos. So that might be a weak spot. I don't know, you know, why it doesn't have better coverage as close as it is.
Thank you. Obviously, we need the representation, the operating representation that shows up to the operating company. And probably the brochures, I don't think we produced the brochure for next year.
They're down. The contract ended at the end of September.
Yeah, and so that's in the startup phase for the first quarter to get back in those racks. So we've gone out of them for since September. But we had a really good September and October. It shows you how good they do.
Randy, I had a couple of hundred left last weekend for the model train show. This one wasn't the best train show, it's kind of a traveling junk show. There were a lot of people there. We put out those brochures, and we were there about an hour, hour and a half, and most of them were gone in that time.
Great.
And I've got some more to take to the next one.
Thank you for doing that. I don't know what we have left at this point, but clearly make sure you get what we got, because I'd rather have them in someone's hands than in a drawer someplace. Absolutely. Other input? Yeah.
What would it take for New Mexico to put a sign, well, they already have, they changed the sign, and coming from Taos, they changed the sign to say, C&TS Railroad, you know, fall to 85. they put it on the other side where they want you to go over.
64.
Yeah, 64 to 84. What would it take to have a sign on both places? To give people the option. Is there any way we could look into that?
We could probably have our executive director send a letter to the highway department.
Yeah, put two signs up.
Transportation, Department of Transportation, because they're the ones that do the signs. We could make that kind of request.
Yeah, because we should have one, and they should wish.
You ever see him? Our executive director?
Once in a while.
Can you send a letter to the Department of Transportation asking for that?
Check. I think I have a contact person already.
Yeah, but if we, you need to make the request in writing, so. Thank you. Thank you. Other input. I received a letter from William Reed, who lives back east but loves the Cumbres and Toltec, and asked that I would, he asked first if I would read a letter, and I told him yes if he made it brief, and he sent it 3 pages, so I'm not going to read it. And I told him I wouldn't read it if it was that long. But he basically is writing to suggest that the commission and the operator and the friends need to focus more attention on the historic accuracy of work that's done on the railroad. And he said it's very concerning to many of us who were actually there when the DNRGW was in operation to see how the preservation of many historical assets are being done incorrectly and having them presented to the public in that fashion. The aim of this request is to bring attention to several areas of concern and hopefully get something established by the commission to gain control of the preservation of historic assets. And he suggests that we, of course, you know, when you want to fix a problem, you create a committee. And so he suggested that we would create a committee to provide oversight and guidance on such projects. You know, and I wrote back to him, and I thanked him for his interest and for presenting this to us. And I have, commissioners have a copy of this, and I have some, since I'm not going to read the whole thing, I have some other copies of it here available if anyone would like to have it. And Tim, do you have it yet?
No.
Okay, well, you certainly have one with your name on it here. I responded to him, and I suggested to him that the clearly all the members of the commission would I think share my thoughts on this, that we're keenly aware of the need to maintain historical accuracy whenever possible, and that by agreement we rely on the friends for this purpose, and that none of the current commission are historic rail buffs, and none of us probably bring the proper amount of expertise to ensure accuracy. I said we look to and rely on the friends to protect and restore the historic components, and for them to bring to the commission's attention when and if the operator is less, because in this he suggests that the operator will change things for the sake of a movie set or something and then not bring it back the way it was. And I suggested that we really look to the friends to be the watchdog. And I also suggested that if there are that many people who care, that I hope they'll make their presence and their voice known through the friends, because that's the purpose of the friends. And I, for one, have a bit of a problem with those who love to criticize but don't want to get involved. And so I suggested to him that it might be good to get involved if he's not already. And if he is, so what I'd like to do is make sure that both Tim and Elmer, I'll give you a copy of this, of course, too, but that we would ask that under unfinished business that you kind of look into this and give us a report back at our next meeting, if you could, Tim, from the standpoint of the friends, because I think this commission totally relies on the friends to work with the historic components. And, you know, if you all don't get something right once in a while, that's fine. It happens. But we want to be as accurate as we can whenever we can. So.
Well, Randy, I get emails and calls, and our members are very passionate. There aren't many things that you can sneak by it. Not that you're trying to sneak anything by it, but, you know, also try and take the broad brush approach, you know, and I think sometimes our membership can be a little narrow-minded. If the rail's not running, we aren't around. Maybe they don't like hearing that said, but no, I want to look at that and respond. So.
Well, and again, I definitely thank Mr. Reed, and I do thank Mr. Reed for his concerns and the passionate the items that he has, and he has a couple of particular items in here that I think we would like to hear back on, and if there is a need for some kind of ongoing committee, I think that we can certainly look at creating that at our next meeting. And I also have, the commission has told Leo that anytime any modification to the railroad is planned as a function of operations or whatever, the commission needs to be advised. And it really should be the commission to decide whether they want to make that alteration or not. And that's not something that the operator should have to shoulder without our support. So we have given that request to Leo. Yeah.
I have one as well.
Yeah, go ahead.
An email from Carl Lehman.